think it's time to try defying gravity.
Oh, good morning, Broadway.com. It's me, your fly girl. I know you don't recognize me because I'm in bed. But this is a very exclusive episode of Fly Girl. I thought I would take you guys through my day. A lot of you have tweeted and asked me what it's like to kind of prepare for the show. And being Elphaba, you're pretty much preparing for the show the second you wake up. It is Tuesday morning. I'm rocking a green hairline from the night before. Isn't that nice? I'm on my green pillowcases with my green sheets because that's what all the other Elfies tell you to do. When you start becoming Elphaba, you get green sheets, green pillowcases. And your life is this pretty much all the time. Isn't that nice? Look at these ears. You see that? Excellent. That's pretty much your life. At first, it's really upsetting, and then you start to wear it like a badge of honor. And you just feel like, yeah, I'm green. What of it? So anyway, this is my morning. I wake up and make the decision that I'm going to get out of bed and start trying to get my voice going. So come with me. Okay, so I'm sitting at my kitchen table, and this is how every morning pretty much starts for me. That would be a really great bowl of fruit. It's one of my favorite things, and all those berries are in season, so we go for those. A cup of coffee, which I think is so important. Elphaba's, we have to give up a lot to do this role, but coffee, I was not down to give up. I said I will drink enough water to be able to have my coffee in the morning because it is that special to me. As my Katie Rose Clark puts it, her first cup of coffee is like a warm hug in the morning, and I'd agree. And then I've got my vitamins going on here. Let me show you what I got. I take some Ester C, I take B complex, give me a little boost, and I take calcium because I don't drink milk. Most of us can't really have dairy doing this part. It gives us a lot of phlegm, a lot of mucus, and we don't need it in our lives. So I use a non-dairy creamer in there and I take my calcium. And then after I eat, guess what's happening? The steamer. We start every morning with a 10-minute steam before we really start to sing. It's very important. I steam quite a bit. You can get these steamers at Duane Reade. They're very cheap. And I have one here and I have one at work. And I really like to steam. It just opens things up and just feels really good on your cords. And yeah, so eat, vitamins, steam, shower. Okay, everyone, I am showered. I am out in the world. It is a beautiful day in New York City. See it behind me? And you are off on a day with me to see what the heck I do in the daytime. And today, I have a lot on the agenda. My first stop, my Mecca, my home, the Westerly Market. Yes, folks. The Westerly Market on 54th Street and 8th Avenue. This is the place where I get all of my goodies for the show. Okay, our trip to Westerly was quite successful. I am now in front of our theater. Here is our stage door. Yes, the Gershwin. And I'm gonna drop off my stuff and get ready for my next little appointment. So let's go inside. What's going on in here? Oh, hey, Carlos. This is Carlos. He's our doorman. Say hi, Broadway.com.
Hey, Broadway.com.
You got my dressing room key? Fantastic, yes. Thank you. I'll see you later, Carlos. Gonna go on our elevator here and head up
to the stage level, which is where my dressing room is.
This elevator ever
closes. There we go. So yeah, basically I stop by the theater quite a bit to drop stuff off. Our theater is definitely our home away from home. And when you have, you know, a great dressing room and a nice space, and you create a nice space, you really like to come and hang out. It's a great place to have in Midtown to just kind of drop stuff off or relax for a bit or pee. All those things are nice. So I'm going to check in and then I am off to the chiropractor, another weekly Elphaba adventure. All right. So, I came in here. I'm going to show you guys what I pick up at Westerly. I start with some organic lemon echinacea throat coat. The people at Traditional Medicinals used to give us this at Godspell and I loved it. The next thing is my Olba's pastilles. You guys, these are so legit. They open you up. They're super menthol-y, and I love them to use during the show. I'll pop one in, and they're kind of chewy, so I can kind of keep it in my mouth while the show's going on sometimes. And they just really open me up if I'm feeling a little clogged, a little congested. You know, there's a lot of stuff in the air in general here and out in the theater, and so I love to have these. These I live by. As well as my Grethers pastilles. These are also a huge secret. Actually, funny enough, Miss Julia Murney, who is a fellow Elphaba, dropped off a few of these for me on my first night, which was amazing. And she said, you know, she used these all the time. They're wonderful. I like the black currant, but there's also a red currant flavor. Oh, last but not least, if you're feeling a little under the weather, this is a new thing. I just was instructed by my director and friend, Mr. Joe Mantello. This stuff is called Cilicia, and it's totally homeopathic. You take it if you're starting to feel a little bit sick, a little coldish. There's a lot of colds going around right now this summer. And so you take these, you just let them melt in your mouth. And they're supposed to help fight your cold and make it kind of get through it really fast. So I didn't want to take any chances. I woke up feeling a little blah. So we're going to start these bad boys. Oh, I want to show you this fantastic gift from the amazing designer, Miss Deborah Littman. She has designed some nail polishes in honor of the Wicked 10th anniversary. Here they are. They're so pretty. I love them. They are three different colors. They say Wicked on them. Aren't these cool? I believe they're going to be sold at Sephora for the 10th. This one is called Popular, obviously. This one, Defying Gravity, amazing. And this sparkly one, which is my favorite, of course, One Short Day, so cool. Deborah Littman, amazing. Pick up your nail polishes, will you? All right, now off to the chiropractor to get my neck cracked. Okay, everyone, I'm back from the chiropractor. It was amazing. I feel like a new person. I wasn't allowed to take you back there. The doctors, they don't like to be videotaped. I don't know why. I don't get it. I wanted to take you into my ENT as well, and he said no. But I also had a really great ENT session. Yes, for those of you wondering, I do go to the ENT once a month and get my cords looked at, make sure they look good, make sure they're healthy. It's very, very important that you take care of your cords. They are your money. And Elphaba, she's a big thing. So I go in once a month and just check out, make sure nothing's changed. And so far, so good. Yay! Anyway, we're back at the theater. We're in the dressing room. Say hi, Kath.
Hi.
Kathy's already here. She gets here way before me. What do you do, Kathy, to get ready for my entrance?
I take care of the... I look at the costumes. Mm-hmm. I make sure that any repairs happen. I open up the room. Mm-hmm. I get your tea water ready. Right. I get the steamer ready if you want it.
That's right.
Change your water out. Clean the refrigerator. Scrub the carpet.
Okay. You know what? Now you're lying. Now you're lying. You're acting like Cinderella. How dare you?
I know. I'm down on my hands and knees, scrubbing. All dressers do that.
Wow. She is a fibber, everyone. But she does have to get all my costumes ready, and they're ready to go. My steamer's ready to go, so I'm going to probably steam again to get ready for the performance. And yes, I have my little tea kettle. and I'm going to do some tea. And I usually start warming up, not until right before the show starts, after I greenify, because I've kind of spent all day talking, and, you know, it's enough. It's enough for me to just get a few minutes right before the show starts. But for now, steam, I shall. Oh, look who just walked into my room.
Oh, hey.
So, Derek, this week I kind of took everybody through, like, a day in the life of Lindsay and how I kind of maintain my health for the show. So, I'm wondering how you maintain your health, like, vocally and physically for the show.
Well.
Like, what do you do?
Well, did you show them that?
I did, the steamer.
Yeah, the steamer.
I did not tell them who taught me about the steamer. Would you like to share? This guy.
Actually, no. I've bit it off of a bunch of other actors. It's an actor's secret. Yeah. But yeah, it helps keep the inflammation down in your throat before and after shows. We also have the Immune Plus Emergency.
Ah, yes. That's your go-to.
My go-to when you're starting to feel a little under the weather.
What flavor do you like?
I like the citrus.
Ah.
Yeah. Because the orange tastes kind of funky sometimes. The citrus is good. Oh, there's a wellness formula. Did you show them the wellness formula?
I didn't, but you can get that at the Westerly as well.
Yeah, it's called Wellness Formula, and that helps if you feel like you're getting sick or you've come up with something, and just take a bunch of it, and it helps knock it out faster. Zicam.
That's right, you like the Zicam.
Lozenges are good if you feel like you're catching a cold and you want to get rid of it before it
really starts. You're like a doctor over here.
See, I have a drawer at home with all my drugs.
Really?
Yeah, it's pretty impressive.
Sick.
Hi, my name is Brian Waney, and I have a QVC problem.
Wait, what are these? Are these actually sponges?
Yes, these are Joe Campanelli's diamond microfiber sponges.
Wow.
I purchased them while watching TV at Wicked.
You get all 12. And I'm Todd, and Brian Waney has a QVC problem.
Say what you guys do in the show.
I'm an onstage swing.
Amazing. What does that mean?
It means that I'm in the opening number, one short day, and then I bow.
If anybody's out, which hardly ever happens, everyone's hardly ever out here.
Everyone. We have such a good cast. They're always all here.
They are very good. Oh, look.
Oh, hello, TV
My
Land.
Old pal, Mark. I'm going to say hi, Broadway.com.
Hi, Broadway.com.
Mark, what do you do here at The Wicked?
I am Chistery.
Yes. Whose monkey's that? My monkey.
Oh, that's not my monkey costume. Never mind.
Aww.
But I am your monkey.
How long have you been here, Mark?
I have been here for 4 years.
Wow. And behind you is Mr. Travis. Say hi, Broadway.com. Tell them what you do in the show.
I'm a dancer in the show, in the ensemble.
What kind of special things do you do?
I massage Lindsay's back between scenes.
You're not supposed to tell them that. Quiet. Oh, look, photobombing. Say hi, Craig.
Hello.
Craig, what are you doing? You delivering?
I'm delivering monkey masks.
Look at that.
Magical.
Why do you deliver them every night? You collect them?
We're full service here at Wicked. So it's like the state of New Jersey. You're not allowed to pump your own gas. Pick up your own monkey mask.
Oh, wow. I didn't know that. Hi, James. Say hi to Broadway.com.
Hi, Broadway.com.
James, what do you do in the show?
In the show, I get to twirl the ribbon and all
that stuff. Yes, honey.
Living my life.
You live your life twirling that ribbon.
Gymnast.
And show them your hair. Bend over.
Yeah, I was going to.
That is a wicked streak, honey. Look at that. Isn't that amazing? Yes, with those champagne food hands. This is Colby again. You remember him from last week.
Fight call. I'm in my underwear.
What's happening right now?
Blow drying,
getting that mohawk going?
Wicked hair. Shout out to my friend Chris.
Aw, hi Chris. And Colby, what do you do in the show?
I'm in the ensemble. I'm the lifter.
Yes, he lifts everybody except me. Thanks a lot.
Anytime.
Hi, honey.
Hi, Dad. This is Michael DeVries. He plays my dad.
Yeah. I was really hungry, so I'm eating my Subway sandwich.
You're eating your Subway sandwich?
Can I say that?
Of course you can.
Fabulous. My Subway sandwich.
And how long have you been in the show, Michael?
This 3 weeks ago is my 8th anniversary.
Holy moly.
Yeah.
That is so awesome. You've loved it here.
I love it. Yeah. It's great.
Yeah.
It's great.
And you play many tracks in the show.
6 different roles.
Wow.
13 costume changes.
Whew.
Yeah.
That's something.
But I'm your dad. That's really the bottom.
That's right.
Line
that's what I care about is that you're my dad.
Yeah.
Put on your thing. Get your thing. This is Adam.
Hey. How's it going?
Now, what do you do in the show?
I'm in the ensemble.
Uh-huh.
Sing, dance.
Yes, honey, live.
you know.
Are you a monkey?
No, I'm not a monkey.
Okay. People like to know who are the monkeys and who aren't the monkeys.
Yeah.
So
not,
you're a guard.
It's not exciting like that.
You're a guard.
Guard.
You hold me back.
Mm-hmm, I do.
Mm-hmm.
Hey, Brian.com.
This is Brian.
How's it going?
Brian, what do you do in the show?
I'm swing.
So
I,
what is so
understudy and
you understudy like a ton of
yeah,
cars, right?
Yeah, a lot of the guys. And
and how long have you been in the company?
I started in with the LA company in 2007, so on and off for 6.5 years.
That's amazing.
Folks, that's it for this episode. I hope it was informative. I wanted to answer, I had so many great Twitter questions, and so many of them were about health and vocal health and how we maintain a day, and so I feel I answered a lot of them today. Tune in next week. We'll have a very fun, exciting episode, and that's it. Bye! Oh, I have to go. And goodness knows the wicked.
With you and I defying gravity, they'll never bring us down.